Hello my dearest friends, welcome back to our channel. It is finally spring in Russia. It's the last day of Maslenitsa, and today I'm going to tell you about the Maslenitsa traditions in Russia, about this holiday, and to show you something interesting. Let's go! Our Russian Maslenitsa is my favorite holiday. It's not just a holiday actually, but it's a big festival. And I love it very much. That is why every year I like to tell you about it and to show you our local celebrations. Fortunately, this spring started with the good news that the Volgograd authorities finally allowed to hold mass events in the open air after the long period of restrictions. And that's the reason why Maslenitsa 2021 became even more important to all of us. It is the beginning of a new time and of a new year. Maslenitsa is an Eastern Slavic holiday that was celebrated by the ancient Slavic folks in the pagan times before Christianity and has always been a very important festival that symbolizes the border between winter and spring. During the Maslenitsa week, we cook special pancakes, Russian blini, that symbolize the sun. Eat them with jam, honey, sour cream, Russian famous condensed milk, and sometimes even with caviar, fish and cabbage, or any other filling that you can only imagine. We also drink a lot of tea and also go to visit our friends and relatives. We invite guests to our place, have parties outside, and visit different concerts, public events and celebrations. The people go to work as usual, but during the whole week we celebrate it by the whole country. Russians learn about Maslenitsa traditions in their childhood. Every kindergarten and every school organizes its own Maslenitsa party that is preceded by a lecture about the meaning of this holiday. It's origin and tradition. The ancient Slavs used to call this day New Year's Day, and they used to burn a scarecrow of winter to say goodbye to the cold season. It was done on the last day of the Maslenitsa fest, called Provody, a send-off. But now every Maslenitsa party ends with this ritual.
It seems to me that it's not the warmest spring day, but we hope that after this holiday everything is going to change and we are going to finally meet our spring. To see all these green leaves and warmth, enjoy the warmth. And the party is already the end, the final part of the party is finally starting. This is the schoolyard. The children are going to make a big circle. Everyone is taking photos. On Sunday, the last day of the Maslenitsa Fest 2021, we went to the local equestrian sports club Babri to celebrate Maslenitsa with the godmother of my children and amazing horses living there. There was a wonderful traditional celebration there with Russian folk music, pancakes, tea from the real Russian samovar, and different entertainments. I want to tell you how we really celebrate Maslenitsa here in provincial Russia. That is why today I want to take you with us and show you what we did on this good sunny day. The last day of the cold season 2021. There's a kitty there. Кисок. Кисок. Масленица is the time when you can enjoy authentic Russian culture. People listen to Russian folk music, dance traditional dances, and try to wear something traditional. For example, a famous hand scarf that foreigners like to call babushka, and that you all know because the Queen Elizabeth II likes to wear it, and even some American rappers also like to do it. There are different contests here for the children. They can participate, win something. So nice. And there you can ride a horse. Пойдем.
Три, поехали! Голова пытается догнать хвостик!
О, there is a balalaika.
Ну, не страшно.
Самовар.
Ваши аплодисменты нашему участнику.
Баранки.
Это еще не все, вы не расстраивайтесь, кто-то участвует, у нас еще игры и конкурсы продолжаются. И на этот раз мне бы хотелось наших маленьких участников попросить вывести сюда родителей, пап, мам, дяди, тети, всех вытаскиваем. Конец каждой ленты. И по моей команде... Нам с вами, уважаемые участники и капитаны, нужно натягиваем так вот, прям в самый конец этой ленточки становимся. Еще. Вот прям за конец ее берем. Смотрите, какая она длинная. Нам с вами нужно заплести косу из этих красивейших лент. Как вы понимаете, плести ее нужно будет, перебегая с одного конца на другой. Главный приз получает команда. Обе команды получают одинаковые. Я не люблю, никому настроение портить. Поэтому все молодцы, все старались. Детки будут рады, счастливы, а ленточки...
The only thing that I dislike about the modern Maslenitsa Fest is that after baptizing of Russia, it became connected to the Orthodox Christian calendar. And now it is celebrated according to it before the beginning of the Great Lent. This calendar changes every year, and sometimes we celebrate Maslenitsa even in February. Of course, it's fun and illogical. Originally, the pagan Maslenitsa week ended on the day of the vernal equinox, as this day used to be treated as the real day of the beginning of spring. In the ancient times, it was the beginning of a new year, full of hard work for our ancestors. But it was also a very happy time. The ancient Slavs celebrated the fact that they managed to survive the cold Russian winter and not die from frosts and famine. That is why they were happy and partied hard. And we nowadays keep this tradition alive. There are always a lot of competitions for children and grown-ups, and only the strongest and the most nimble one can win them. These qualities were very important for the ancient Slavs. That is why they honored them. But today we just play and have fun. While I was watching the horses performing with their trainers, my children seemed to have won all the candies at the festival. It was especially good that this day was really warm and sunny, even though the week before it was cold and even snowy. This year, the last day of Maslenitsa was the 14th of March, but the beginning of this spring was really cold. As I've already told you, the Maslenitsa week contains 7 days of celebrations. It starts on Monday and ends on Sunday. Each day has its own name and traditions. But the last day is the most important one. It's the time when we burn the symbol of this fest, the scarecrow winter. There is always the main scarecrow in each city or town, just like the main New Year's for a tree here. It's funny that the main scarecrow in Volgograd this year was in a mask. I'm sure you understand that it was because of the pandemic. And now we all hope that by burning this scarecrow, we said goodbye to the previous hard year and finally got rid of all the restrictions in our hometown. And now we are ready to meet spring 2021, full of warmth, fun and interesting events, and of course full of new good vlogs.
party. That was all for today, my dearest friends. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.